Hi everybody, this is Lowell Hostot and we're talking about vision today. And particularly today I wanted to talk about vision, not only your own vision, but the vision that God has for your life. You know, everything that we do in life we can do either by the flesh or by the Spirit. And I wanted to share some of these thoughts with you from Isaiah 40, 28 through 31. It says, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, does not become weary or tired. His understanding is inscrutable. He gives strength to the weary, and to him who lacks might, he increases power. Though youths grow weary and tired, and vigorous young men stumble badly, yet those who wait for the Lord will regain new strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles. They will run and not get tired. They will walk and not become weary." And God never becomes tired. He's youthful forever. He's powerful forever. And, you know, in our humanity, we, even young people who are supposed to be at the prime of their lives, get tired and can stumble badly, according to the scripture. But the people who are not going to stumble are the people, regardless of their age, are those who are trusting in the Lord. In 2 Corinthians, Paul says, and he said to me, "My grace is sufficient for you, for power is perfected in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, I will rather boast about my weaknesses so that the power of Christ may dwell in me." And so he's talking about leaning to God's Spirit instead of his own humanity. And when God is in our lives, that's where we have our strength. That's where we have our power. In Zechariah 4:6, Zechariah says, "Then he said to me, 'This is the word of the Lord to Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit, says the Lord of hosts.'" So not by might nor by power, but by my Spirit. And in Psalms 147, 10 through 11, it says, "He does not delight in the strength of horses, nor does he take pleasure in the legs of a man. The Lord favors those who fear him, those who wait for his loving kindness." When the Israelites would go out to battle, one of the greatest things that they could have was a good, strong horse. You know, they had their armor, and they had a big, strong horse that they could go into battle with. But the psalmist here is talking about the importance of trusting in God and not the accoutrements that we have as human beings. And then Proverbs 3, 5 and 6 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and do not lean to your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make your path straight." And so I wanted to share kind of a thought that maybe some of you might have not considered, and that is that we can do even good activities or even spiritual activities, seemingly spiritual activities, from the arm of the flesh instead of leaning to the Spirit. And it is possible to be in the flesh even when you're trying to do good works or do something that's profitable. Ultimately, those things are not going to be profitable. In Colossians 2:23, it says, Paul is admonishing them, "These are matters which have to be sure, the appearance of wisdom in self-made religion and self-abasement and severe treatment of the body, but are of no value against fleshly indulgence." And he was talking about people who were living by the law, people who were going through rituals, people who thought they were being very religious, and they were doing it all by the arm of the flesh instead of by the Spirit. But even fascinatingly, Paul, when he was soul winning in the book of Acts, it says this in Acts 16, it says, "And they passed through the Phrygian and Galatian region, having been," notice this, "having been forbidden by the Holy Spirit to speak the word in Asia. And after they came to Mysia, they were trying to go into Bithynia, and the Spirit of Jesus did not permit them." You would think, well, you know, I'm soul winning. I'm doing the work of the Lord. I'm doing something good. I'm doing something that God wants me to do. But these guys were sensitive to the leading of the Holy Spirit as to what he wanted them to do. They didn't just say, okay, we're going to go soul winning today. No, they listened to the Holy Spirit. You know, "I don't want you to go there right now. I want you to go over to this other place." And so, it's about being led by the Spirit of God. It's about trusting in God, no matter what you're involved in, asking him, you know, inwardly in your heart, "Lord, is this what you want for me right now? This very moment, is this what I should be doing? Is this helpful for your kingdom? Is this..." Asking the Spirit, you know, the Spirit is there with you. He's there with you forever. Jesus gave him to us to lead us and to speak to us, to be our teacher, our counselor right now. Jesus is in heaven, the Father's in heaven, but the Spirit right now is with us. And so having a heart that's attuned to the Holy Spirit and asking him moment by moment throughout your day, is this what you want for me? That's what gives you vision, God's vision for your life. And in Romans 8, 12 through 14, it says, "So then, brethren, we are under obligation, not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you are living according to the flesh, you must die. But if by the Spirit you are putting to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are being led by the Spirit of God, these are the sons of God." So that's the whole point here, is to learn to be led by the Spirit of God. And you'll know his voice. Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice." You do know his voice, but it's just up to each one of us to turn our hearts towards heaven and ask, even moment by moment, throughout our days. And this is how we have success in life, not just by doing the things that we want to do or things that we think we ought to do. It's by trusting in him and having that relationship with him on a moment-by-moment basis.